Hi. In this video, I'm going to introduce you to StringBuilder. StringBuilder objects are like string objects, except that they can be modified. They are frequently used for creating and manipulating string information that needs to be changed dynamically. You can think of StringBuilder objects like variable length arrays that contain characters. StringBuilder objects have a capacity that specifies how many characters can be stored at a given time. Let's look at an example. Let's say I have a StringBuilder SP and I initialize it with a StringBuilder that I get from my default constructor. At this point, my StringBuilder SP does not include any characters, so the length is 0. However, capacity by default is 16. If I keep adding some characters, my length is going to reflect the change. So in my case, I add 5 characters, length is 5, capacity is still 16. If I keep adding more and more characters, eventually my capacity fills up. I add even more characters and the capacity is automatically expanded. In case you're wondering, should I use string or should I use StringBuilder? We have a clear guideline. We should prefer string, unless the StringBuilder leads to code that is more simple, more clear, or the StringBuilder leads to better performance. More simple code I might have if I need a functionality that is provided in a StringBuilder method, for example. The StringBuilder provides a method called reverse, which allows us to have a very elegant and simple implementation of a palindrome. Better performance is provided by a StringBuilder when we have a character sequence that needs to be modified over and over again, especially in combination with loops. Let's have a look at the constructors. I can create a StringBuilder with my default constructor that gives me an empty StringBuilder, capacity 16. I can initialize it with a character sequence or a string, or I could set the capacity up front. This is especially interesting when I'm going to add item after item and I have a good idea how big my length is going to be. This repeated adding of items would cause my StringBuilder to resize the capacity over and over again. It's a more efficient way to create an appropriate size up front. StringBuilders allow us to access individual characters. Character at allows me to read the character on a given index. Set character at allows me to write on a special index, and I'm going to write the character provided. And delete character at removes the character on the specified index. It also has an append method, as a matter of fact, not one but many. Those are overloaded versions for primitive types, strings, character array, and object. Append takes the string representation of that element and appends it at the end of the sequence. The compiler can use append to implement the plus and plus equals string concatenation operator. Also notice the return types. All of those overloaded append methods return StringBuilder. This allows chaining. So I could say my StringBuilder dot append this, dot append that, dot append newline, etc. StringBuilder also provides a fairly large number of overloaded insert methods. Once again, they all return StringBuilder, which allows us chaining. Like here, I called my StringBuilder instance SB, and I could say SB insert this on position 10, dot insert that on position 20, etc. StringBuilder has a number of additional methods, I'm just going to point out three more. One of them is replace. It allows us to replace the characters that start on this index and go up to end exclusive with whatever the string contains. It has the method reverse. This is the method that can be so nicely used to implement a palindrome and for many other purposes. It also has two methods called substring. So I could say, give me the string that starts at a given index or that goes from a start to the end. Upper end in the Java API is exclusive. In case you've heard the word string buffer and you wondered what that is, string buffer is functionality-wise just like a string builder, but it is thread-safe. When you do multi-threaded programming, a string buffer might be what you need. When you have a single-threaded application, a string builder might be a great choice.